and it was time to really. We are in Munnar. We are going for sightseeing. It's 11 now. My Royal Enfield gave me some problems even yesterday. Now the starter isn't working. Maybe the moisture would have messed it up. We are just going to get it checked in the garage nearby. But guys, Arid is trying. He's trying to kickstart my bike because he always wanted to. Arid is having a tough time kickstarting a bike. Don't accelerate. Fail. Are you riding this? Okay. Arid is giving another try. He's going to kickstart my bike. Hope he succeeds. I give one. Atta boy. He's taunting me. My self-start isn't working. Arid is a bitch. Alright, we are heading to some dam over here. We were initially riding to Anirankal Dam, but the local guide is... oh shit, look at my accent. I have started talking like the Kerala people. Okay, so... yeah, local guide said that there is a dam nearby, which is a tourist attraction spot. So we are heading there. Mattupetti Dam. Alright, we are heading to Mattupetti Dam. Man, look at this place. Gorgeous, absolutely gorgeous. Those are the tea plantations right there. We navigated through this route in the night in the pitch dark conditions, but in the morning it's so bright, it's so beautiful, and it's amazing. Oh, this place is absolutely gorgeous. I'm so loving this. Without the luggage, without any payload, this bike is fun to ride. You can maneuver it pretty damn well. You know, this is a paradise. To be very frank, this is absolutely a paradise. And riding in such weather, you know, it's almost 12 now, but you can't feel the heat. That's because of the vegetations here. It's lovely. It's cold, and look at the trees, man. I love this place. It's scary as hell in the night, guys. And we rode almost 80 kilometers in the night in this ghat. And I was totally paranoid, maji, fatlele, literally. And I was trailing behind. And these guys, you know, rode till 30 kilometers, I suppose. And I was riding alone for 30 minutes. Around 30 to 40 minutes. So we have been planning this trip for a month and a half. We started planning in the month of December. At the end of the day, you know, I think I'll be having a satisfaction that this trip was totally worth it, because it taught me many things. To be very frank, I don't consider myself a hardcore rider. All the obstacles I had encountered on this trip are the sign that you're gonna come across things that you might not have even considered that it will happen. I mean, life throws you many surprises, unexpected things. You just have to learn to cope up with it. It just helps you be better, be a better version of your former self. The channel name, Chasing Nirvana. You know, few of you have asked me why am I chasing Nirvana. So I think this is the feeling that I could relate to when I ride. You throw back all your life's problems and you're searching for something. You're searching for peace. You're searching for tranquility. And I think riding a bike gives you that. I mean, this was a feeling that I thought will best suit as my channel name. I've had a very bad patch in the past. I've been through a lot, academic-wise as well as relationship-wise. So when this speed art entered my life, it changed for better. So I don't have many friends, and I'm very choosy about them. So the friends that I make, that I continue to be in touch with, are made for lifetime. Alright, enough of bugging you guys. I just wanted to release it, wanted to throw it out. That's the reason I thought of undertaking this road trip. What's up guys, we'll be leaving for Kodaikanal tomorrow early morning. I wish we could have stayed a little longer at Munnar because there were many places to visit. We just couldn't. It has started feeling cold now. It's around 6 o'clock and I am going to check my air pressure. Alright, so both of these guys are at the room. They're syncing their videos. That's Dhanuj, he's from Kerala. He's here for the trip. And I think I got myself a subscriber. Who's in the drive? Ah, damn, so good. Holy shit, dude. Alright, I guess we are closing into the end of the car. Well, not really. Kodaikanal Wildlife Sanctuary welcomes you.